months ago, we all stopped, as we do every year, for our great race. And this time, we watched in awe as two great horses took our breath away.
Mighty Power, the leader. Doremus is coming at him. Doremus after Mighty Power. Mighty Power and Doremus, they hit it. Oh, it's close. Doremus lands. It's a photo in the Melbourne Cup.
Sadly, today, for Mighty Power's trainer, Jack Denham, his effervescent rider, Jim Cassidy, and Fruit and Veg King owner, Nick Moraitis, their mood is now likely to mirror that of Greg Hall and the connections of Doremus on that first Tuesday in November. A leg injury means that Mighty Power isn't with us today, but the ingredients are still there for an epic battle at Fabulous Flemington. And the big crowd might just witness another one of those magic moments that make racing great. Can the Cox Plate winner Dane Ripper triumph over Doremus and company to give the master Bart Cummings an incredible 12th Australian Cup victory? And then for good measure, throw in another million-dollar showpiece, the mighty Kiwi Zonda taking on the cream of the local three-year-olds in the Cadbury Guineas. Oh yes, the Carnival of Champions today lives right up to its name. And Network 10 is along for the ride. Welcome to our live and exclusive telecast of Australian Cup Day 1998 from the course of history. Hello everyone, on a magnificent Monday in Melbourne, we're set for a magnificent day of racing. It's a day of champions, and with me, I have a champion of days gone by in Sub-Zero. And another name's going to be added to the list today in the 1998 Australian Cup. Good on you, Subby. Thanks, Graeme. Have a good day. Well, I hope you have a good day, everyone, because we're set for a wonderful day of racing. As I said, it's Australian Cup Day. We also have the million-dollar Cadbury Guineas. Truly is one of the great days of racing on the Australian turf. And it all gets underway in about 20 minutes or so with our first race for telecast, and that is the fourth event on the program, the Devon Park Stud Stakes. Here's the program as it stands. After that, we'll have the Cadbury Guineas race 5, then moving on through the Claudia Australia Plate. Race 7 is the Amy Australian Cup. $1.25 million in prize money. Then the 4-20 stakes, and we'll close our telecast today with the Scalzo Food Industries Welter, race number 9. It's time now to take a look at the scratchings for our telecast races, and the first of those, race 4, as I said, coming up in round about 20 minutes, and the scratching here is number 9, and that is Kahuna Queen. Races 5 and 6 are clear of scratchings. Unfortunately, as we said, race 7, the Amy Australian Cup, you can take out 3 Willoughby and 6 Mighty Power, 3 and 6. From race 8 on the card, scratch 5, Dry Humour and 12 City Hall. And from the last event this afternoon, the scratchings are 3 Sir Knight, 4 Oregon Star, 14 Chicago O'Brien and 16 Gibran. And joining me here at Flemington, of course, on this wonderful day, and very excited to be here, no doubt, Joe McKinnon. Hi, Joe.
Good afternoon, Pete.
Well, we've been looking forward to this day for a long time, haven't we? And even the scratching of Mighty Power can't dampen our enthusiasm for what's going to be a wonderful race.
No, that's right, Pete. This really is the grand final of the Autumn Carnival. And despite the absence of Mighty Power from the Australian Cup, it's still going to be a very intriguing race and a very wide-open affair. I'm looking forward to it.
And, of course, it's not the only feature we've got here today, because we've got the best of the three-year-olds, New Zealand versus the best of the Australians in the Cadbury Guineas.
Yeah, well, Zonda looks like the hot favourite for the Guineas, and he really is looking to redeem himself from a disappointing run last start. But at the same time that he made a disappointing run, General Nadeem did, and he redeemed himself here on Saturday, and I don't see why Zonda can't do the same today.
Well, I must say, you look a picture today.
Thank you, Pete.
And so does the weather here at Flemington. We can sum it up pretty easily. Fine and sunny, around 25 degrees today for this great day of racing. Well, I'm happy to say that an old mate of mine is back here, and a very familiar face here at Flemington. After all, he won 2 Melbourne Cups. He's always with us here at Melbourne Cup time, and he's reunited with his old mate Banjo, Johnny Letts. G'day, Lettsy.
How are you, Pete?
I'm well, how are you?
Oh, I'm pretty good. I'm having a good time down here. Actually, it's great to be back.
What about the state of the track out there, John? All important.
Well, Pete, I just went along with Banjo and we had a look around, and he seems to think it's pretty good. He said he wouldn't mind even running today.
Really?
Yeah, but I'd say the inside and the outside, very, very close to each other, Peter. There's no difference in the track. Just that I think when you race down the inside, you've got a rail to guide you, and I think this helps the horses. So I'd say if you want to have a bet and the horses are drawn inside, don't be worried about it, because I think that's the place to be.
Well, we're going to put you to work and talk to all the winning jockeys as they come back to scale today. I'm sure you'll enjoy it.
Well, all the jockeys, when they leave the room, I'm the first guy they want to talk to, Peter, after a race, they tell me.
Good on you, Johnny. Johnny Letts, he'll be talking to the winning jockeys today. Let's have a look at the tote figures as they stand. First of all, for the Australian Cup, and Doremus is round about the $5.80 mark. Quarter Bronner, 18. Always Aloof, 7. Delinquent, 11. Can Bart Cummings win it for a 12th time with that horse, or maybe with Dane Ripper? Marble Horse, surprisingly the favourite at 360. Rustic Dream, 12. Batavian, 18. He's Regal, 52. Dane Ripper's come up very good odds at $4.80, and Second Coming at $11.50. As far as the Guineas is concerned, that's race number 5, the first of our features, and Zonda has come up very short at $1.90. Gold Guru ran about the $9 mark as excellent value. El Mirada, 6.60. Mustang Red, 20. Prince Standard, 44. Bohemia, 16. Vitronite, $12. Il Don, 9.30. Swing King, 27. Ancient City at 38. And Lahar is at 47. Well, that's what's happening as far as the tote punters are concerned, but of course there's going to be a lot of activity today in the betting ring, and to keep us up to date with everything that's happening there, let's go down and say good afternoon to Anthony Mifford.
Good afternoon, Pete, and as you can see, I came prepared today. Might and Power was my big go. Unfortunately, he stayed home. He's got a hoof injury and has stayed at home, and punters will be looking for something else to punt on today. Dane Ripper is the go. As you said, great value on the tote at this stage. Going by doubles bookies, it seems that she should start about, you're looking at it probably half the each way quote, maybe a bit shorter depending on the confidence down here. Plenty of punters were down here ready to punt Might and Power. Unfortunately, he's not here, but it is a great race, as you said. In the Guineas, we're looking at Zonda. It'll be about the same quote, probably shorter, about half the each way quote, and would expect it to come in considerably. Plenty of money there for Zonda. So that's an early check-in from me, Pete. It's back to you. We'll keep you updated throughout the day.
Good on you, Anthony. Anthony Mithen, who'll be in the betting ring right throughout our telecast today. Well, this is a great time of the year. Of course, Melbourne Cup Carnival is a legendary time of the year, not only here in Australia, but around the world. And you can join us for one very special day of racing in November. Here's how you can enter our very special competition. How would you like to spend a day with the stars during the 1998 BRC Spring Racing Carnival? Today, Network 10 and Sport 927 are giving away a prize for two people to be our VIP guests on Oaks Day. Included are return airfares to Melbourne, two nights accommodation, limousine arrival at Flemington, members tickets, and if that's not enough, you'll be lunching in the Channel 10 marquee. All you have to do is tell us which horse won the 1997 Australian Cup.
Juggler just in front. Gold City pegging it back with the Big O coming at them. It's Gold City, the Big O, the outside, they hit it. Oh, Jesus is close.
To enter, simply phone 1902 555 614. Tell us which horse won last year's Australian Cup. Leave your personal details and you're in the running to join us here on Thursday the 5th of November for Oaks Day. You've only got until 4:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to register your entry. We'll announce the lucky winner later in today's Australian Cup Day telecast. So I hope you'll be able to join us here on Oaks Day, and you can enter as many times as you like. Well, as you can see, these magnificent animals are in the mounting out here, and the jockeys are about to make their way over, like Brett Preble in the all-white colours of the club, for the fourth event, the Devon Park Stud Stakes. It's time to commence at 20 minutes after one. We'll take a break and be back to look at the runners in race. Cup Day 1998, wherever you're joining us live around Australia. Stay with us for the next 4 hours because we've got some wonderful entertainment, Joe, and the first of our races is coming up, and let's take a look at the tote call for race 4 as they go to the stalls for the Devon Park Stud Stakes. And here we can see number 1 Sunny Lane has come up very big odds, around about the $30 mark. Big odds for Sweet Delight as well. Miss Tesla 10, Ascorbic 30, Prefer an Angel 14, Bionic Bess 11, Chevelle Place number 7 well in the betting at around about the $8 mark. Von Ann number 8 is 5 $5.50. The favourite is number 10, Blue Storm. Pretty short, $2.60. Cristalero, 31. Queenstown Kate, 10. And around about the $94 mark for number 13. And that is Amy's Dream. Well, let's have a look at these runners, and let's start with Sunny Lane. And this could be a very big weekend for the Goggin family, because already we've seen Matthew Goggin win at Royal Canberra yesterday, and Charlie, his father, trained Sunny Lane.
He does indeed. This horse hasn't raced since 14th of December, and that was in Hong Kong in the Vase, where she ran third, but she does like it longer, so a very rough chance here today.
Sweet Delight, number two. She's got ability on her day.
She certainly has. She can put in the odd cheeky run. She's had a bit of a freshen up, slight chance.
Miss Tesla's very consistent, Joe, number
three. She is, absolutely. A real model of consistency, this mare. She's very fit. She did appeal to me in the mounting yard. She has to be one of the main chances.
I think a Scorvic would be better off with a wet track.
Yes, I totally agree with you there. Prefer her another day.
Okay, that's Miss Tesla we're taking a look at now. And Ascorbic number four, as we said, probably does need a wet surface. That was Chevelle Place number seven going through. What about Prefer an Angel number five?
She comes into this race with a chance. I think she'd be fitter for her run last start at Caulfield, so watch out for her.
Righto, well, that's Ascorbic, so we'll try and show you as many of these horses as possible, but we'll quickly run through our thoughts. What about Bionic Bess?
Not here today.
Chevelle Place, I thought, is very consistent. Excellent chance of good each way odds.
She put in a great run last start to rattle home to finish second to the very consistent Blue Storm.
Von Ann number eight. Definitely a chance here at each way odds.
My only query is that she did look very sweated up in the yard.
Blue Storm's the favourite. She's short enough though.
Very short, but with a strike rate like that, how can you go past her in this race?
And probably the other one is Queenstown Kate, number 12, Joe.
Yeah, she's had a bit of a freshen up. She's one to watch also in this race.
Okay, there you saw the odds for Blue Storm, and Queenstown Kate is showing round about the $10 mark on the tote, number 12, to be ridden, as you can see there, by Damien Oliver. So they're heading to the stalls. That's Chevelle Place on the way to the gates. We'll take a break and be back with the first of our races for telecast, the Devon Park Stud Stakes, in just a moment. Runners are at the stalls on the far side of the track at the 1400 for the Devon Park Stud Stakes, and as they're about to be placed in the gates, I'm unhappy to say that my old mate Roy Higgins is not feeling the best today and won't be joining us here on Australian Cup Day. So Roy, I know you'll be watching and we do send you the best, but you've got a very able replacement, Higgs, and that is a fellow who's well known in the riding ranks, and he's not a bad judge either, Alfie Matthews. G'day, Alf.
Thanks, Peter, for your kind words.
Well, it's nice to have you here, but we do miss Higgs, don't we?
Oh, most definitely, yes. Very astute man and a genius in his own right.
Well, you're going to be giving us all of your thoughts throughout the day, except for race six, because you're actually riding in that. But I know you can't tip, but if you were riding something in this, what would you like to be riding?
Well, Peter, look, I just think the way the race is going to be run, there'll be good speed from inside gates, and I just thought Von Ann, where it's drawn, irrespective whether they do go fast or they do go slow, it'll be perfectly suited.
And the hardest to beat, maybe the favourite, Blue Storm. I thought it was short enough, really.
Hence my comments. Blue Storm, I think from its inside gate, it's likely to actually get pushed back a little bit unless Jimmy gets a little aggressive. If he does get over aggressive, it won't suit the horse. I've put it in actually for third, and I've put Chevelle placing because it's drawn out a little bit, because again, I think the speed is the important factor in this race.
We'll look forward to seeing you throughout the day.
Thank you, mate.
Alfie Matthews, he'll be giving us his thoughts. Now, the map, 1400 metres is the start here, and they start over on the far side of the track, and as we've said so many times, almost continuously turning until about the 450, and then they flatten out for the run in here in the Devon Park Stud Stakes. As they are starting to be loaded up, let's go down to the betting ring, find out the latest information with Anthony Mithen.
Yeah, well, Pete, I can tell you that Blue Storm is short enough. You're probably getting just over flip of the coin odds, so not much value there. Chevelle Place has been backed in to beat it. It was showing third pick on the tote screen as I look up there now. It's into second pick and solid. Of course, Von Ann, the other one in the market, showing 630. That's about what you're getting here. So back to you for the race, Peter.
Okay, Anthony, they're lining in. There are the famous colours, the colours that were carried into second place in a Melbourne Cup here by Kingston Town, and that is Queenstown Kate, which is over on the inside with Damien Oliver. Von Ann's just gone up in the gold with the purple Maltese cross, and the gates being filled quite quickly here. Chevelle Place is in blue and white colours, and it's going to be the last one to move into the outside gate. There's Damien just steadying Queenstown Kate. Chevelle Place about to come up to complete the line. Prefer an Angel going in too, closer towards the inside. It's a beautiful day here at Flemington. I hope you can stay with us for the Australian Cup, the Cadbury Guineas and all of our racing entertainment. And the man who'll be behind the binoculars today, courtesy of Sport 927, is Brian Martin.
Line is good. Set to go. Racing. Cristalero a little bit slow into stride with Sunny Lane, and away fast Prefer an Angel with Sweet Delight on the inside. Settling down, Blue Storm was right behind them, and going forward, Miss Tesla, and further back, Von Ann up running fifth. When they settle at the 1,200 metre mark now, Prefer an Angel a half, Miss Tesla two, further back in the race then. Came Sweet Delight around the outside of it, Von Ann. A length further back, Blue Storm running fifth, one to Amy's Dream, and then Queenstown Kate from Bionic Bess and Ascorbic. Two to Cristalero, who's well back in the race now with Sunny Lane, and three out on the outside of those, last of all, Chevelle Place. 850 metres to go now. Prefer an Angel, three quarters, Miss Tesla. One further back, three deep is Von Ann. A length into Blue Storm, running fourth on the outside of Sweet Delight, fifth. Then Amy's Dream and two to Queenstown Kate, followed by Bionic Bess. Then Ascorbic, well back Cristalero. Chevelle Place with one behind at Sunny Lane at the 600 metre mark. Up nearing the home turn now. Prefer an Angel about a half in front of Miss Tesla. A length further back, Blue Storm has had a good run most of the way. Cassidy about to ease out now. Outside him, Von Ann from Sweet Delight, and a gap to Amy's Dream. She gets out, Blue Storm, and she travels pretty easily now. Goes up to Miss Tesla at the 300 metre mark. Cassidy looking over his shoulder, then Von Ann, Sweet Delight, nothing from behind, and Jim lets the mare down, and away she goes, Blue Storm. Oh, she quickens like a good mare. She races three in front of Miss Tesla. Von Ann further back, Sweet Delight running on fairly well. This wins easily, Blue Storm, never going to be beaten. Wins 2.5 on the run home to Miss Tesla. Von Ann third, fourth Sweet Delight. Then Sunny Lane made good ground from Bionic Bess, the outside Chevelle Place. Further back, Cristalero, Prefer an Angel, back behind those Amy's Dream, Queenstown Kate, and Ascorbic is last of all.
That's the way that favourites should win. Number 10, Blue Storm. It has trotted in. Jim Cassidy couldn't hold it slow enough, Joe, at the 300 metre mark, and when he said go, she did.
Oh, very impressive performance from this mare.
Yeah, she was absolutely in a hand canter at the 300 metre mark, and has won very easily. Number 10, Blue Storm, ridden by Jimmy Cassidy, so maybe some consolation there for him. He's had a disappointment with Might and Power not running in the Australian Cup later. Number 3 is second, Miss Tesla, battling on well, and she's so consistent. She's run a lot of placings, and third placing going to number 8, Von Ann, so the trifecta wasn't very hard to have there. Numbers 10, 3 and 8, and the time for the journey was 122.4, which is pretty smart. 122.4 is 1.8 seconds outside the record, which is held by Lovey. Well, there's Jim Cassidy coming back to scale.
And Pete, that win does take Blue Storm's strike rate to amazing 8 wins from 9 starts.
There's Blue Storm getting the upper hand now on the outside. Miss Tesla is in the red and white colours over on the inside, getting the better of Prefer an Angel. That's Von Ann in the gold colour starting to run on. But you can see there that Cassidy never really had to call upon everything from this mare, and just hands and heels to the line. She had them covered at the 300. When he let her down, she went very quickly, put three lengths on them, and that was the end of the penny section. And Johnny Letts is out there with Jimmy Cassidy, speaking to him just as he did on Melbourne Cup Day. Letsy?
Hey, Jim, 122 this filly. How'd you feel going to furlong? Would it be like if you'd have been a punting man, you'd have put the house on?
Yeah, and the neighbours, mate.
Fair enough, Jim, but she's good, isn't she?
Yeah, she's really improved. She's given me a bit of feel at seven. You know, I even think she's a big hope of running a good mile, John.
Well, Jimmy, she just seems to be getting better and better. It's just a shame that she's been beaten once, isn't it? Because this filly could have gone through unbeaten in anything.
Yeah, especially when I was on her. Well, Jimmy, myself, though, too.
Well, Jimmy, I don't think you want to get off her at all now. They'll have to get a crowbar to get you off, won't they?
Well, she won with a leg in the air today. She got to the furlong and said it'll move on a Letsy, and she picks them up and puts them down the right way.
Jimmy, she seems a lovely mare to ride. She's tractable, gets a good spot, doesn't she?
Just takes up a spot, travels, and when you say go, she's ready to go.
Good luck to you, Jimmy. I'm sure we'll be interviewing you plenty of times with this mare.
Good trainer, this bloke, mate.
He is very good.
Yes, yeah, certainly a good trainer, Russell Cameron. He's got a very good reputation. And, well, we don't have to tell you about the reputation of the jockey. He's one of the best in the land. Jimmy Cassidy returning to scale on Blue Storm, and Anthony Methan now has Russell Cameron.
Russell, there's a bit of a story behind this mare. She had her problems early. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, she had a lot of problems early. She was going to be put down at one stage, and she cut half a hoof off, her hind hoof, and into the fetlock joint as well, and infection set in. We had to work. She had to be... she was locked away for 6 weeks, I suppose, 2 months, and to get a backspin great.
Surely you didn't think at that stage she'd ever race again. Did you see her just as a broodmare prospect?
All we were worried about at the time was trying to save for a broodmare, you know, so it's really been nice on the Cape.
Where to now?
Coolmore Classic.
good on you. Thanks very much, Russell. Well done.
Well done to Russell Cameron, the winning trainer there, with that mare Blue Storm. So impressive. And quick time, 122.4. Jimmy Cassidy returning to scale now. Unfortunately, he won't be doing that after the Australian Cup this afternoon with the scratching of Might and Power. But always good to see him in the winner's circle. And hopefully, a little bit later on, we might have a chance to talk to the Melbourne Cup winning jockey. 10, 3 and 8. We'll take a break and come back with the correct weight signal and the dividends on the Devon Park Stud Stakes at Flemington very shortly.
They're off, and O'Reilly jumped fairly well as they race down past the 1,000 metre mark, and Warbot doing it well in the leader. About a length to Regal Cent, a length and a half further back as O'Reilly nicely positioned, nearing the home turner with 700 metres left to travel. Warbot held together by length from Regal Cent, but it's all Warbot. He's much too good and is going to both him with a Cadbury Guineas. Warbot